Okay, let's do some math for fun. Here we are going to solve these two equations. However, we have to use the Lambert W function to help us out. So if you don't know what Lambert W function is, be sure you guys watch my other video. I will have the link in the description for your convenience. And after you watch that video, come back here and pause the video and try these two questions first. Okay, we are going to solve that first. However, let me remind you guys what we need from the Lambert W function. So recall that whenever we have an expression in the form of x times e to the x, when we have this, what you want to do is you can apply w to it, and then you are going to end up with just x. So as long as the front and the exponent are the same, and e for the base, you can apply w to it, and then you can pretty much reduce this expression to just x. And we'll be using this a lot. And I will also remind you guys, in order for us to make sense of the Lambert W function, of course, we will have to talk about the domain. So whenever you have W of x, this only works in the real sense when you have x is greater than or equal to negative 1 over e. Right? This is the domain for the Lambert W function. Of course, we will keep everything real in this video. If you graph this and graph that, you will see the graph and y equals to 2, they cross each other one time. So you do know we have one real solution, right, for both of these equations. Now, let's get to work right here. Oh my god, because who put the square for the x? Right here, I just want x to the first power times e to the x. If they are the same, then I can just apply the w on both sides. Who put the square? Yes, that person was me, okay? So you might be thinking, can I just somehow get a square right here? But no, because if you square both sides, e to the x and then square, you multiply the powers, so you get e to the 2x. That's not what we want. Therefore, let's try to reduce that square. How can we do that? Well, if you didn't have e to the x, how would you get rid of that square? Yes, you take the square root on both sides. So we will take the square root on both sides right here as well. So let's go ahead and take the square root here and do it here. But of course, remember to put a plus minus. And yes, I mentioned that both of these, they only have one solution. And now we have the plus minus. So we have to be careful with that, especially if we have to talk about from the domain, right? Anyway, I cannot cancel anything out, anything across anything out like the Google days, unfortunately. But I do know that x to the second power in the square root, this is just x. You don't put the absolute value because you took care of that on the right-hand side for the plus minus already. And when you have e to the x power in the square root is the 1/2 power. Half times x is x over 2. So now you have x over 2 like that. And this is equal to plus minus square root of 2. Now, the exponent is x over 2. Remember, exponent and the front have to be the same so I can apply the Lambert W function. How can I make the front the same as x over 2? Yes, you got it. We just divide both sides by 2. So let's go ahead, divide this by 2, and divide this by 2. That's pretty cool, isn't it? If you want to rationalize the numerator, up to you, but I'll just leave it like this. And I will now apply the Lambert W function because we are ready to go. So we can do it like this, W of this guy and W of that guy. Well, on the right-hand side, we technically are saying we put the plus or minus inside of the Lambert W function. But you have to notice that negative square root of 2 over 2, this right here is actually smaller than negative 1 over e. This guy is approximately negative 0.707, while negative 1 over e is approximately negative 0.3678. So if you want to round that up, so it's about negative 0.368 like this. But it's, you know, of course, I'd round it. Yeah. This is smaller than that. So this is outside of the domain. Therefore, you have to get rid of the negative. So this is how you get rid of the negative. Legitimately. Now, on the left-hand side, front and exponent are the same inside of the W function. So I just get x over 2. That's very nice. X over 2 equals W of positive square root of 2 over a regular 2, like that. In the end, how can we solve for x? Of course, just multiply both sides by 2. Yes, x equals 2 times W of square root of 2 over 2. Oh, so many 2s are here, so good, right? So this right here is the answer in the exact form. And just to make you guys feel better, that will tell you this right here, if you enter this on Wolfram alpha, and once again, W is the product rule, product log, you get approximately 0.90120. And yes, if you put this into the x and the x there, you end up with approximately 2. So really, really close. But this is the exact form. Anyway, now, number 2. Oh my god, who put the plus here? Yes, it was me. Now, let's see, how can we solve this? We do have a solution, so let's see. Huh, I want to have this and that being the same. This is not multiplying. I don't like that. So perhaps let me move this to the other side, yeah? So I will have e to the x equals 2 minus x. So far, so good. And somehow I want to get this to a multiplication. I'm not going to multiply anything right here. This is a negative x. Let me divide both sides by this guy, e to the x, e to the x, which is the same as saying multiply by e to the negative x. So somehow I match the negative x. Uh-huh. On the left-hand side, I just have a nice number 1. And then on the right-hand side, let me put this down as 2 minus x. And let me write this as e to the negative x. So far, so good, yeah? The negative x match. I need a 2 in front. I need a 2 right here. Well, e to the 2 minus x is the same negative x plus 2. If you are adding the exponent right here, that means you multiply e to the second power. So I will just multiply this guy by e to the second power. Of course, we do the same thing on the other side. Perhaps let me write this down first on the left-hand side. Now I will have this, which is 2 minus x, and then e, this and that, we write it as 2 minus x. Look at that. It's so much fun to solve these kind of questions. Who says algebra is boring? Can you solve this? Yeah. Give this to algebra students. They will have fun too. E to the second power times 1 is e to the second power. This is the legitimate number. And now you see, so good. And of course, here is the time to use the Lambert W function here and also here. Unfortunately, I cannot cancel anything. I cannot do a cross. But I know. From the left-hand side, I will just put this down, namely 2 minus x. That's equal to, well, this is the legitimate number. If you use a calculator or Wolfram alpha, you get, you know, you will get a number, but already as W of e squared, like that. Well, I'm going to move x to the other side, but I'll put the x down first. And then I'll move this to the other side, which is 2 minus that. So it's 2 minus W of e to the second power. Whew! Oh my god, this is so cool. And yes, if you use a calculator, well, sorry, you have to use Wolfram alpha, something more high tech, you get approximately 0.44285. Yes. Anyway, let me know if you guys like this video, and if you guys are new to my channel, please subscribe. I like to do a lot of math for fun videos and math lessons for you guys. So, you know, please subscribe. Thank you guys so much. And also recommend me to your teachers, friends, crocodile, chairs, table, podium, laptop, microphone, hard drive, whiteboard, markers, all that stuff. Anyway, thank you guys so much.